This is Loaded, the album Lou Reed and the Velvet Underground wanted to load with hits for the radio. In 1994, Duke Yule would say, on Loaded there was a big push to produce a hit single. There was that mentality. Which one of these is a single? How does it sound when we cut it down to 3.5 minutes? So that was a major topic for the group at that point. The album starts with Who Loves the Sun, with Yule in the vocals. It is a very nice song with simple but well-written lyrics. It basically says, who cares about anything when you are heartbroken? In this album, Yule played many instruments and recorded the lead vocals in many of the songs. There also are some live versions of this song where Lou Reed sings the lead vocals. We move on and listen to one of the most popular Velvet Underground songs, Sweet Jane, a classic riff from the band with an amazing well-written melody. In 1970, with the release of the album, Sweet Jane was modified, the bridge of the song was cut. According to Reed, it was an unauthorized re-editing. Later, in 1972, the full version would be released in Velvet Underground's Live at Max's, Kansas City. During the recordings, Maureen Tucker wasn't available because of her pregnancy. Therefore, the band went through several drummers, including Yule's brother, and even a producer. In the words of Duke, Billy was a pretty good drummer at the time, so I said, do you want me to get my brother? They said yes, so he came out and played. He played live and when we were doing some album cuts for Loaded. I've always been a frustrated drummer, so I played drums on some of those. The producer actually played drums on one, but we cut it out. Then there was a guy from Long Island. No one knew his last name. He said it when he came in, and I'm sure the people who paid him knew it, but when it was time to do the credits, no one remembered it, so he just appears as Tommy. Regarding this issue, Lou Reed would say, Loaded didn't have Maureen on it, and that's a lot of people's favorite Velvet Underground record. So we can't get too lost in the mystique of the Velvet Underground. It's still called a Velvet Underground record. But what it really is something else. The third track is Rock and Roll, another well-known song of the band. I personally love this song's lyrics telling the story of Jenny, whose life was saved by rock and roll. The rhythmic guitar and loose vocals make this song perfect. In the notes of Velvet Underground's box set, Peel Slowly and See, Lou Reed wrote, rock and roll is about me. If I hadn't heard rock and roll on the radio, I would have had no idea there was life on this planet. The next song is Cool It Down. On this one, I will tell you my own interpretation on the lyrics, considering it. There aren't official comments or interviews about it. First, we have the main character looking for Miss Linda Lee, who apparently would be a prostitute. She's got the power to love me by the hour. Prostitutes charge per hour. The character also mentions, hey baby, you want it so fast? Don't you know it ain't gonna last? Of course, you know it makes no difference to me. Well, prostitutes often want to make their clients come as soon as possible, so their work will be done in less than an hour. An hour of struggle having sex with a random man they don't really like. Musically, it's a very strong piece with a nice acoustic sound, double voiced, what makes the song really interesting by having two different takes of the vocals, one pan completely to the right and the other one to the left. This creates an amazing effect that drove me crazy the first time I listened to this song. New Age is our fifth track in the album. Here we have Duke Yule on the vocals one more time, encouraged by Lou Reed. In its original form, it was about Reed's girlfriend at the time, Shelly Alvin, and included a possible reference to Reed's bisexuality. The later studio version is written from the point of view of a fan addressing a fat blonde actress. There is another version of New Age with Lou on the vocals. It's interesting how the band can be very noisy sometimes, but can also write beautiful soft melodies in songs like this. Next is Head Held High, crunchy rock and roll guitar and nice raspy voice by Lou. The welcome piano, back vocals and percussion by Duke Yule is also a highlight on this song. About the words, this song is not directly about Lou's personal issues with his family, but it might have certain references hidden in it. As you might know, around the time Reed was a freshman at New York University, he experienced intense psychological issues, including mood swings and depression. Reed's parents became worried he might kill himself and put him through electroshock therapy, an experience that made him resent his father for the rest of his life. Rumors have persisted that Reed's parents were also concerned with Reed's bisexuality, but his sister, Mary Reed, has refuted that. My parents were many things, but homophobic they were not. For all those whose families' lives were damaged by the pervasive medical thinking of the time, I hope to offer solace and comfort. As a teenager in Long Island, New York, Reed avoided socializing and was very anxious, sometimes hiding in his room to avoid meeting people. Panic attacks and social phobias beset him. He possessed a fragile temperament. His hyper-focus on the things he liked led him to music, and it was there that he found himself. Lonesome Cowboy Bill is the seventh song in Loaded. These songs feel different to the other tracks in the album. We have Duke in the lead vocals one more time, as well as in the backing vocals. It feels like a Duke song, a song that would fit in Squeeze, the unpopular last album under the name of the band. Still, it is a very nice song. It has a good melody and rhythm. It kind of helped the album to feel fresh. Next we get is I Found a Reason, a love song with a soft voice by Lou that would remind us to songs like Sunday Morning or I'm Set Free. The lead guitar played by Sterling Morrison has beautiful arrangements. It reminds us how Sterling was the perfect fit for the band. Apparently, he also did part of the backing vocals in this song. Duke does a great job once more in the backing vocals, however, around the minute 2:23, you can hear some kind of mixing or recording error. For a second, Duke's voice becomes a little louder and is suddenly cut. The song steals a beautiful piece. It is time for the ninth song to show up. Train Round the Bend. The rhythmic guitar actually feels like a train coming round the bend. It has a great feeling. The bass lines are nicely done, with some Beatles-like little arrangements. An interesting drums arrangement in between that refreshes the song, and once more the raspy version of Lou's voice panned all to the right, which gives a different feeling. Finally, we have Us With Nothing, with Doug on the lead vocals one last time. This is another well-known song by the Velvet Underground. Simple chords and a smart melodic walk. A beautiful soft beat through the verses and choruses. Except at the end where the climax of the song appears. In the words, we have these homeless people, Jimmy Brown, Ginger Brown, Polly May, and Joanna Love, all of them with miserable lives. Joanna Love can't even tell night from the day, maybe because of drugs or something else. It is worth to mention that all guitar solos on Rock and Roll, Cool It Down, Head Held High, and Us With Nothing were all actually played by Yule. Now, what in my opinion makes that song awesome, it's the multiple interpretations it can have. You can listen and sing this song from different points of view. The people in the song are just miserable and they have nothing at all, or maybe they are all suddenly in love, then realizing the person they love is not worth and simply has nothing at all. Or the most plausible, it is just an irony from Lou, talking about people who's actually suffering, making the words sweet, the most ironic through the whole album. Loaded got very positive reviews. In the Village Voice, Robert Christgau said the music was genuinely rock and roll but also really intellectual and ironic. The rich singing embodying the paradox. Music journalist Michael Ross regarded the album as a near-perfect rock album, while Eric Killinger from Pop Matters called it a great pop album. The Velvet Underground is without a doubt one of the most influential bands of all times. So Loaded is definitely a must listen.